Creamer Media in Johannesburg, this is the Real Economy Report. The City of Johannesburg, in conjunction with a range of partners, collaborated to facilitate the Joburg Market Day for agricultural and agro-processing sectors. This focused on targeting entrepreneurs and export possibilities for fresh produce. Mia Breytenbach tells us more.
The Joburg Market Day aimed to present opportunities for the agricultural and agro-processing businesses in Gauteng. By exhibiting entrepreneurs' market-ready products that will attract potential international market interest and opportunities. Member of Mayoral Committee for Economic Development, Councillor Ruby Matang, highlighted the importance of the Joburg Market in assisting the City of Johannesburg in creating a more conducive environment for the agribusiness sector.
Very often food or agriculture is forgotten as an integral part, input to the sustainability of cities, and is taken as a given variable. Food economy is not just about the sustainability and well-being of citizens of any one city, but rather as an economic growth tool.
The Joburg Market is the largest of the fresh produce markets in the country, by volume and the value of trade. Many farmers' products find their way into the Joburg Market and are then distributed into neighbouring municipalities, provinces and neighbouring countries and beyond. Matang noted that the objective of the city was to enhance the agricultural value chain and create a more conducive environment for the farmers, market agents and agro-processors to grow their businesses and to contribute to the growth of the economy. Matang also emphasised the need for the country to assert itself on the opportunities for the international trade presented by the global economy.
In order to trade to be fully empowering and able to bring about economic changes in the lives of the continent's people, trade amongst African countries needs to be increased, but more importantly, to be strengthened. We need to set ourselves on the opportunities for the international trade presented by the global economy, and ensure that local business take advantage of the opportunity to export South African products to the markets outside of our borders. So local business key in the sector of ensuring that we nurture and work together towards the export market.
The City of Johannesburg has developed an exporter development program able to assist enterprises at different stages of readiness for the export market. The products of these entrepreneurs involved in this program were on display for traders and investors at the market day. Business sectors showcased at the event included fine foods, such as tinned food items and biscuits, beverages, such as wine, juice, milk and water, as well as perishables, such as fresh meat, fruits and vegetables, cheese and fresh cut flowers. Commodities such as maize, sugar, beans, nuts, as well as fast-moving consumer goods were included.
We have amongst us a determined group of young entrepreneurs who are making a name for themselves. They have broken into the agricultural sector, overcome entrenched barriers, and are building formidable businesses.
Executive Mayor of the City of Johannesburg, Councillor Parkstyle, also highlighted the collaboration between the City of Johannesburg and the Joburg Market.
As the City of Johannesburg, we have also made strides in the economic development of our people. This includes agriculture and, based on this, agro-processing. Through the Johannesburg Market, we have created opportunities for growth and jobs. Our market agents and tenants have created employment for over 6,000 people. 1.3 million tons of fruit and vegetable is sold annually, and I'm happy to announce that the market yielded 5.3 billion rands turnover for the 2014-15 financial year. Ladies and gentlemen, Joburg Market is the largest of its type in the continent and a shining example of how opportunities for entrepreneurs can be created in the agro-processing industry. Economic development and growth is critical for Joburg as the commercial and economic hub of South Africa.
Tao added that agriculture, and through it agro-processing, is central to the city's plans, as the city's entrepreneurship development in this area will bring about work opportunities. For example, the city has more than 4,000 agro-processing companies in the areas of fresh fruit, processed foods, fine foods and beverages. The city has also established breakthrough service delivery-oriented interventions for businesses in the spirit of getting the basics right, according to Tao.
Through these, we have created business clusters in priority sectors. This will assist in creating connections and synergy within the agricultural value chain. The most central of these breakthrough interventions is for the city to improve competitiveness through a package of services that are paramount to attracting and retaining business investment. In partnership with the Small Enterprise Development Agency, the Gauteng Growth Development Agency, we train aspiring and existing exporters in the agricultural and agro-processing sector through the Exporter Awareness Program. Companies are trained on product development and how to obtain investment in the agro-processing sector. The city's Trade and Investment Promotion Unit also facilitates workspace requirements in collaboration with the Johannesburg Property Company. This to provide access to land, as well as workspace site development approval in partnership with the JPC and City Power for export-ready clients. This project is being rolled out in collaboration with various city departments, entities, and business chambers. In addition, the city is in talks with the Johannesburg Property Company in facilitating the use of depleted buildings or dilapidated buildings around Joburg. Our intention is to turn them into urban agriculture, enabling agriculture and agro-processing to be established.
This particular type of agriculture and agro-processing would focus on perishable products, such as green vegetables and mushrooms, herbs, fresh milk, eggs and poultry. These are items that can be grown within confined spaces within the city.
That's Krumo Media's Real Economy Reports. Join us again next week for more news and insights into South Africa's real economy.